Welcome to Art That Plays and Prays. My name is Ginger. In this episode, I'll be making this oil pastel painting using Mangyo Gallery, which are artist-grade pastels, and this Mona Lisa linseed oil. I'll explain the process and why sometimes it's necessary to use linseed oil. And when I'm done with the technical side of the tutorial, I want to talk about something faith-building. For this painting, I've chosen a scene of a house located at the corner of a street. I'm using it as a metaphor to illustrate how in life we don't really know what's around the bend. We don't know what to expect when life takes a turn, just as we didn't foresee COVID coming at us at the beginning of this year. But I want to paint a bright and happy picture to indicate that the unknown shouldn't cause us anxiety. For this painting, you'll notice that my sketch is pretty rough. I'm not paying much attention to perspectives or scales. I want this painting to be whimsical, and I want to make the process as relaxing and stress-free as possible. Now, one thing I see often in many YouTube videos is that artists stress the don'ts and do's in creating art. There are so many videos that say, don't do this, don't do that, or your art will look weird. I'm sure if you want to go pro with your art, it will be to your advantage to listen to those technical rules, but I'm not that kind of artist. I'm not too stringent, because I want my students to be free to express their creativity without the burden of rules, without focusing too much on what they're doing wrong and being inhibited by that fear of trying. Because ultimately, art is self-expression. That said, if you're following along and you're drawing this scene as well, don't worry if your staircase is uneven, or maybe if your tree looks like a lollipop, or if the cobbled walkway has irregular tiles. That's perfectly okay. Let's just have fun here, okay? I actually have another Mangyo oil pastel video on this channel, and that painting doesn't even use any solvents. In that tutorial, I only have the pastels and paper. Those were all the materials I used. If that kind of painting interests you more, I've linked the video in the description below. You can check that out later. But in this painting demo, however, I'm using linseed oil. So you might ask, is that really necessary? Why do we need linseed oil for this painting? Actually, I want to show you that sometimes we need solvents to get into the finer details of a painting. As you can see, oil pastels are like huge chunks of crayons, right? They don't have the pointed tips. It's kind of difficult to draw or color with it unless you're covering huge spaces. With linseed oil, you can define the boundaries of your painting better, and you can draw the thin lines and fine points that are difficult to do with oil pastel crayons alone. Blending is much easier if we use solvents. Linseed oil works just like water for acrylic paints. It helps smooth the pigments. It sort of dilutes the oil pastels to make the paint more fluid and easier to manipulate. Of course, you can also blend your colors with your fingers if you prefer it that way. But sometimes, especially for intricate designs where you need the pointed tip or the edges of a brush to do the trick, we need linseed oil to get the job done faster. So that's what I'm doing in this video. The process is pretty simple. If you watch till the end, you'll notice that the cycle I'm following is a pattern that repeats. Like first, I lay down the colors I want. I just scribble in any random way. There's no precise science to it. Just scribble away. Next, I use a brush. I dip it in linseed oil and use the brush to blend these colors together. There's no need to overly soak the brush in oil. Just a tiny bit of wetness on the tip is fine. I'm also not using a good expensive brush. For Solvents or chemicals like linseed oil, fast-drying medium, or varnishes, I always use old brushes that I can pretty much throw away already because these chemicals can destroy your bristles if you're not careful to clean them afterwards. After applying linseed oil, I go back in and add more layers of oil pastels. Sometimes I smoothen the paint with linseed again, or sometimes I leave them as is if I want to show texture in the painting, just like what I did with a tree. By the way, I'm using autumn colors in this piece. I'm sort of inspired by the orange and red maple trees outside my home. They're really beautiful at this time of the year. Anyway, before I forget, let me give you an important word of warning. When using linseed oil, please make sure to keep this away from any sources of heat. Linseed oil is combustible, so make sure to work in properly ventilated space and under cool temperatures. If you're using rags to wipe down the linseed oil, keep those rags away from heat as well. You can't really be too careful, right? Now, while I'm working on this painting, I want to share a few personal thoughts. Like many of you, I was very hopeful when this year started. I heard a few people say that the year 2020 forebodes clarity of vision and purpose, that it's a year for us to expect a double portion of blessings and all things good. Like many were hopeful that this year will be a year of breakthroughs, a year when the much-awaited opportunities will finally open. I actually felt the same way. I was kind of ecstatic at the start of the year, and I pray that this may finally be the time my manuscripts will fall into the hands of a literary agent who will believe in me and who'll find it a joy to work with me. December last year, I was so thrilled to fly to Malaysia and meet my family, whom I haven't seen in 25 years. That grand reunion was the most memorable time of my life, and we planned to do it again this year before we knew that a pandemic of global proportions would derail our hopes and lock us inside our homes instead. Many of us never imagined our lives would suddenly turn upside down, inside out like this. It's like we flip the page of a book and just realize we can't continue reading the story because someone tore off the page. Life was like that. We don't know what will happen in the next chapter. What's the story going to be like now that we've been put on hold and we're forced into a new normal? Friends, this may describe your circumstance as well. You walked the street, turned on the sharp corner, and didn't anticipate the scene that would smack at your face. That scene could represent many different things, like maybe a lost job, or an inability to operate your small business, or a compromised immune system that led to complications in your health, or maybe the emotional frustration of not being able to go to school because you just love your teacher so much and you miss the routine of school, even your exams and homework. Maybe you turned the street corner, you didn't expect frustration to well inside of you or depression to debilitate you because of your feelings of helplessness. Maybe you've always been a positive person, but at the turn of the year, you didn't expect the isolation from friends or social distancing to turn you into a grumpy hot mess. Or maybe COVID totally blindsided you when your family or friend lost his fight with the virus. Whatever it is that greeted you when you turned towards the street corner, friends, one thing is sure. Let me tell you, God had it all planned for your ultimate good. It may not seem that way. It may be hard to digest that there's something good attached to something catastrophic. But our logical minds are too puny to comprehend the mind of God. We can only hold on to faith and trust that years down the road, when we already have the benefit of perspective and wisdom, we can look back at the year 2020 and realize in hindsight that God had so much good blessings interspersed with what seemed to our eyes as bad. It could be that this year marks the beginning of a new home business for you. Maybe you discovered you have untapped skills that you never had the courage to sharpen before when you were probably still employed. Maybe this is the year you ended up growing in your relationship with your family because you have more time together at home. Maybe this year you opened your Bible for the first time or prayed for the first time because of extreme need, and probably you found the peace you never thought you could feel under such dire circumstances. We don't really know what good the Lord is weaving through your life. But my friend, know that there is hope at every turn. Yes, there's hope for us who believe God is in control, and with Him, there's no reason to fear. Thank you, friends, for being with me in this creative worship. I hope you like the art and that you somehow found encouragement through the message of this episode. This is again Ginger O'Malley. If you need more doses of hope, I'd like to invite you to visit my blog where you can read devotionals and Bible studies to fill your minds with positivity. The website is gingeromalley.com. Check the link in the description box below. All right, bye now, and catch you again later.